Greetings, everyone. I'm Tammy, your host with Making and Taking Time to Listen. Making and Taking Time to Listen. Today, I came across a video from 2 years ago where a mother lost her son to a senseless violent. He was shot at a gas station. Please listen to her story.
So stop thinking that these blocks belong to you. Love your neighborhood. If you love your neighborhood that bad, go feed that man standing on the goddamn corner who begging for food. Go to Checkers right here. Don't shoot the bitch up. Buy some fucking groceries. That's how you serve your neighborhood. Not fucking up these people's restaurants. Because somebody got some beef with some damn body else. That's not how we settle this. Black lives matter, yeah. But do they fucking matter to black people? Because I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't see a white motherfucker standing out here nowhere but my son dead. Sorry, and I bet you my son was killed by a black person. My son killed by a black person, but we repping Black Lives Matter. If we defunded the police, they wouldn't have came that night to my son, would they? No. So we gotta think about this stuff that we talking. If Black Lives Matter, put them down. If Black Lives Matter, put the guns down and save your sister, save your brother, because mine is gone, because he popped fucking gas. Something we all do out here every day, we pump gas. He did not deserve what he got. I'm sorry, he did not deserve none of it. He did not deserve it. He loved these streets, but he didn't deserve that one. And the one who did it pulled off. Did they get some sleep that night? Probably did, because they ain't got a fucking conscience and they ain't got a heart. But guess who didn't get no sleep? Me. I did not fucking sleep that night. I was at Grady Hospital, holding my son's hand while he was taking the last, excuse me, he didn't even take the last breath. He never got a chance to take a fucking breath from Chevron. He never got a chance. I don't know what you heard on the news, but he never got a chance to take a breath. Never. When they put him in an ambulance, they bagged him. And if anybody know about bagging, they trying to keep you alive till they get you there. Because they already know you're gone. So he never got a chance to take it. I never got a chance to see it. The bullet fragments in his head made his brain like jello. And I don't know if y'all know, but the brain don't fucking heal itself. It don't heal itself. So it don't get a scratch. And you think, oh, well, it's going to heal itself. It will not heal itself. So when you get one in your head, you're gone. They couldn't have gone and picked the fragments off my son's head and bring him back to me. They couldn't do it. I'm sorry if it's uncomfortable for y'all, but I'm going to tell y'all how uncomfortable I am right now. That I got to go. That I had to call the morgue. I had to call the medical examiner. And I had to tell them, is my son's body ready? How many out here made that motherfucking call today? Who made it? I did. Put your hand up if you made a call to the medical examiner today. Because I made it. I made it. And I got to go and I got to get him a funeral. I got to lay him to rest. And he worked for 30. I didn't get a grand daddy's child from me, so I ain't got nothing to pass on. I ain't got nothing to say, all right, little buddy, your daddy gone, but I'm gonna raise you. I ain't got it because he ain't got that chance no more. And I ain't gonna get it from him. All I'm asking y'all to put, I ain't even ask you to turn no motherfucking body in. That's on your conscience if you fucking know. But I'm gonna ask you right now, put them down, y'all. Everybody out here say they love Darian Jester. They love Diesel Promo. They love Diesel Smoking Diesel. They love Fat D. They love the promotion. They loved all of it. Y'all say y'all love it? Guess what? He ain't got no goddamn life insurance. I want to see how much y'all gonna love it. Because I'm gonna leave my motherfucking cash out by here. And I'm gonna see if y'all gonna love it. The same way y'all sending me them prayers. The same way he didn't have it, I'm telling y'all right now, you better get some life insurance on you. But somebody gonna lay you the rest if you don't put the guns down. Somebody got to come out their pocket. Somebody got to do another struggle. And it ain't fair. Somebody got to come out their pocket. Somebody got to do another struggle. And it ain't fair. Because I got to do it. I never would have thought I would be sitting there watching my son's name come across the news channel and say, two people were wounded and one is dead. And it was mine. It was mine that died that night. I got four children. And if Cleveland Avenue know Darian, then they know they brothers and sisters. I got three more left. I'm finna ask y'all one thing. And can y'all give me that favor? It's my one last request. Can y'all motherfuckers not take them from me? Can y'all not take them from me?
Praying for this mom and the family. Tragedy. That's a hard pill to swallow. And recovery, it's a long time. There's no time frame on it. But the violence does need to end. We all need to come up with a better solution, figure out what's what. The census killing, it doesn't make sense. But thank you for making and taking time to listen. Making and taking time to listen. Stop the violence.